we now discuss the solution of a problem from real analysis. The problem is on the image of a continuous map, and this problem appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section B. The problem is, suppose f is a function from the closed and bounded interval 0, 1 cross the closed and bounded interval 0, 1 into the open interval 0, 1 cross the open interval 0, 1, and f is a continuous non-constant function, then which of the following statements is not true? The four options are given to us. Option 1, the image of f is uncountable. Option 2, the image of f is path connected set. Option 3, image of f is a compact set. Option 4, image of f has non-empty interior. Let's now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. We first review some of the results what we know. A metric space capital X is said to be path connected if for all X comma Y belongs to capital X, there exists a continuous function gamma from the closed interval 0 comma 1 to X such that gamma of 0 is equal to X and gamma of 1 is equal to Y. Then for all X comma Y belongs to X, there exists a continuous function gamma like this, then the metric space X is said to be path connected. That is, a metric space X is said to be path connected if any two points in X can be connected by a continuous path that lies entirely in X. We have some theorems to note down. Theorem 1, let F be a continuous mapping of a metric space capital X into a metric space capital Y. Then the first result what we know is f of x is compact whenever x is compact. That is, the continuous image of a compact space is compact. Option 2, f of x is connected if x is connected. That is, the continuous image of a connected space is connected. The third one, f of x is path connected if x is path connected. That is, the continuous image of a path connected space is path connected. And this result normally may not be there in our MSE study. Therefore, I will give you a proof for this result at the end. And note down, a path connected space is always connected, but the converse is not true. Now, we have the two metric spaces, X is this, Y is this. So, given F is a function from X to Y, which is a non-constant continuous function. Let us take down the statement that is given in option 2. The image of F is path connected. Let's see the validity of this statement. Note that X is the closed interval 0, 1 cross 0, 1. This is a metric space. Is path connected. Why? Because any two points in X can be connected by a continuous path lying in X. Therefore, F of X The continuous image of a path connector space is path connected. F of x is path connected by theorem 1. Therefore, the image of F, F of x is the image of F, is a path connected set. So the image of F is a path connected set is true. Therefore, thus the option 2 is true. Option 3, the statement given in option 3 is image of F is a compact set. Note that X is compact. Why? Because it is closed and bounded in R square. Therefore, F of X is compact. Why? Because the continuous image of a compact space is compact by theorem 1. F of X is compact. Therefore, the image of F is a compact set. So, the option 3 is also true. We continue in the next slide. Let's take down the statement given in option 1. The image of F is uncountable. We have the two metric spaces, capital X, capital Y. And we are given F function from X to Y is a non-constant continuous function. Now, since X is path connected, F of X is also path connected by theorem 1. Now, what we do is we take two distinct points in F of X. Let X and Y be any two distinct points in F of X. Now, since F of X is path connected, F of X contains a continuous path. Since F of X is path connected and X and Y are any two points, two distinct points of F of X, so there lies a continuous curve in F of X. So, since F of X is path connected, F of X contains a continuous path gamma from X to Y where X not equal to Y. Now, you have a continuous path gamma. How many points are there on this gamma? That was the question. And the case that the number of points on gamma is finite does not arise. Why? Because gamma is a continuous path. And let's look at the other option. If the points on gamma is countable, then that is, in other words, denumerable, then gamma will be discontinuous. Gamma will be because it is countable, then gamma will be discontinuous. Therefore, this also doesn't arise. Therefore, the number of points on gamma is uncountable. This shows that the points on gamma is uncountable. Now, therefore, F of X is uncountable. Why? Because the points on gamma is a subset of F of X and the points on gamma is uncountable. Therefore, F of X is uncountable. Thus, the image of F is uncountable. So, the option 1 is also true. Now, so far we have shown options 1, 2, 3 are true, and it is a question from section B where there will be only one answer is true. Therefore, the option 4 is not true, and we have to find out that statement which is not true. So, therefore, the option that is not true is 4. So, however, I will establish that it is not true by going by a counter example. Let's look at that example. Option 4. Image of F has non-empty interior. And we go for a counter example. We have this X a metric space, Y the given two metric spaces. Let us consider a function f x to y defined by f of x comma y is equal to the ordered pair x by 4 plus 1 by 4 the first component, 1 by 2 the second component, true for all x comma y belongs to x. It is clearly this function what we have defined is a non-constant function, and it is a continuous function, and it is very easy to verify. Now, f of x, that is the image set, is the set of all those ordered pairs x by 4 plus 1 by 4 comma 1 by 2, where x comma y belongs to capital X. Note that f of x is the set of all points lying on the straight line 1 by 4 to 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 to 1 by 2. So, f of x is the set of all points lying on the straight line in y, 1 by 4 to 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 to 1 by 2, all those. So what is the interior of the set of all points, that is, what is the interior of f of x? That's what we want to consider. So let a comma b be any point in f of x. Then no circular neighborhood of a comma b is contained in f of x. Now why circular neighborhoods? Because the situation is in R square. Is in this closed unit square, and this is the open unit square. So we have to, neighborhood means circular neighborhoods only. So no circular neighborhood of a comma b is contained in f of x, since f of x is the set of all points lying on a straight line joining these two points. So it is a straight line joining these two points. Now, therefore, no circular neighborhood of a comma b is contained in f of x. So therefore, a comma b is not an interior point of f of x. This shows no point of f of x is an interior point. So the image of f has non-empty interior is not true, and thereby the option 4 is not true, and we have to find out that option which is not true. Therefore, our answer is option 4. That is the discussion of the solution of that problem. As I have promised you that I want to show you the continuous image of a path connected space is also path connected, I will give you a proof. The theorem is, if capital X is path connected metric space and F is a function from X to Y, where Y is a metric space, is a continuous map, then the image of F of X is also path connected. Now proof. Proof is very simple. Let X comma Y be any two points of the image set F of X. So then X will be in F of X, means F, then X is equal to F of A and Y is equal to F of B for some AB belongs to capital X. And since capital X is path connected, and in a path connected space, every two distinct points can be joined by a continuous path. Therefore, there is a path that is a continuous function gamma from 0 comma 1 to x. Therefore, there is a continuous path. What do you mean by continuous path? A continuous function gamma from 0 comma 1 to x, such that gamma of 0 is a, gamma of 1 is b. Gamma of 1 is b. So now we have found, because x is path connected, we have found a path from a to b. Now consider the composition of two functions, f compose gamma. What is f? F is a continuous map, and gamma is a continuous, and f compose gamma is also continuous. But you know, f is continuous from x to y, and gamma is continuous from 0, 1 to x. Composing these two things, you will get a composition function f compose gamma from the closed interval 0, 1 to f of x. And it will be a continuous function such that f compose gamma of 0 is f of gamma of 0. that is equal to f of gamma of 0 is a, f of a is equal to x, and f compose gamma at 1 is equal to f of gamma at 1, that is equal to f of gamma 1 is b, f of b is y. So thus f compose gamma is a continuous path from x to y. Where it is a continuous path? From x to y. Where are these x to y? In fx. So therefore, any two distinct points in f of x can be joined by means of a continuous path. There, thus, every two points of f of x can be connected by a continuous path. Therefore, f of x is path connected. Thus, we have proved the continuous image of a path connected space is path connected. And that is the proof of that result. And this result normally may not be there in our MSc classes in some of the universities. So that's the proof of it. And this is the discussion of the solution of the problem from the section real analysis. And the question is based on the continuous image of certain sets. And I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out some more problems on these lines. I wish you all the best. Thank you.